you actually started working on this 4 years ago, and you're just launching today. You call it a new kind of document. It must be pretty special if it was 4 years in the making. What do you mean by a new kind of document?
Yeah, it's a new type of doc. I mean, it starts with a pretty simple set of observations. We think that in this world full of applications, every team we see seems to run on documents and spreadsheets, and all of those technologies and platforms were invented 40 years ago. So we decided we'd start from scratch, build an entirely new type of document. It blends all the best parts of documents, spreadsheets, applications all together into one new surface, and the goal is to allow anybody to make a doc as powerful as an app.
So it's not quite true that the document was invented 40 years ago, or last invented 40 years ago, because Google's got Google Sheets. I mean, Microsoft's obviously in here. You've got Slack with its enterprise software. So, Hemant, what attracted you to this?
Yeah, I think Shishir is doing a good job describing the product. But when you really try the product, you get to start thinking about the use cases that can be used here. The document itself, the metaphor has changed. It's really more of an app. So when you are small businesses today, it ends up leveling the playing field for you in many ways. Rather than having complex packaged software, you can actually have all your workflows beyond there. One of the questions I ask Shishir a lot is, how many companies are fully running on Coda? And it's amazing how many of them are now moving from building documents in these old pieces of software to these brand new Coda metaphor.
But then who's the competition? Is it Microsoft Word? Is it Google Docs?
It's a wide set. People use Coda in a simple use case as taking notes in meetings as an alternative to a document, all the way up to things that you would normally use spreadsheets or databases for, where they're organizing, maybe it's inventory or customers, all the way up to building real applications where you can build systems that can run whole businesses.
Now, you were the head of product at YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
Big job. What did you bring from there to here?
Oh, yeah. Had a great time at YouTube. We were there 6 years. Probably two big things. One is the way we worked. So we ran YouTube basically on documents and spreadsheets. And a lot of how we used those tools inspired a lot of the core metaphors in Coda. And the other one is how the ecosystem worked. The way I often talked about YouTube was that online video would do to cable what cable did to broadcast, and we'd go from 3 channels to 300 channels to 3 million channels, and there'd be all these new makers that were all of a sudden qualified to build high-quality video. So similarly, what we think is happening in software is that there's this set of makers, the people that are problem solvers, tool makers, that can take the problems they see in front of them and build their own solutions. They just need a new set of building blocks to be able to do it. So our goal with Coda is to empower that group of people and, sort of similar to what we did with YouTube, allow them to build the tools that work for them.
And these people sit in every company.
Yeah.
So, Hemant, more broadly, General Catalyst was an investor in Snap. What else are you looking at? What is hot? What is not?
This is a tremendous time for innovation. There's a lot going on in fintech. There's a lot going on in healthcare. And then, akin to Coda's theme, small business software and companies that are leveling the playing field for small businesses is a massive theme. We're early investors in Stripe. You've seen Amazon Web Services and what Coda's trying to do now in terms of a document platform. These are also massive opportunities.
Shishir, you're also on the board of Spotify, which did a direct listing. Slack's aiming for a direct listing. Do you think that was the right call for Spotify? Well, I'm sure you think it was the right call, but how has it worked out? And is it the right call for Slack?
I'm excited to see what happens. I think it's obviously only works for companies that have a few characteristics. It has to be a big enough brand that people understand you, and you have to not need to raise capital. It's an important criteria. But if done well, it can be really impactful. I mean, it's much more cost efficient, but also it levels the playing field for your existing employees and your existing investors with the new investors. So I'm pretty excited to see what happens with Slack.
What are you expecting in terms of exits?
That are really interesting about Slack is it's an enterprise company that can go do a direct listing. Like with Spotify, you would have thought it was a consumer brand and it made sense. But the fact that Slack is this consumerized company, it'll be curious, interesting to see what happens there.
Yeah.